The next stretch, you will reach down the center of your back, like so, making sure to touch your spine, and then press down on the top of your elbow, and you pull down as hard as you can. If you have difficulty with that, you can always prop yourself up against the wall and press like this, making sure to keep it tight for a 10 second hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The next one is the same way. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the opposite one is you're going to pull up the center of your back and press up. If you can reach across and grab your elbow and pull up, that's even better. But in the case where you cannot and you have difficulty getting your hand up the center of your back, you can grab the edge of a door, such as this. And then once you've done that, you just squat down to initiate the stretch for a 10 second hold. 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 10. You can switch hands. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. The next stretch will be to rotate your head 5 times in each direction. You'll probably want to keep your eyes closed for this in case it causes some nausea. So you make slow, careful circles, not to damage your neck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The next stretch is the windmill, I call this. You're going to rotate your arms around at the elbow. When you come into the front, make sure you do not over extend. Stay even with your shoulders. Your hands flat at this point. When you go to the back, don't get lazy on yourself. Go right back with a good push and a stretch at every point of that turn. What we're going to do is 10 times each direction. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 10 times the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then the next stretch is rotation of the knees, which helps limber up the knee joints. You will put a small space between your feet, do not touch them ankle to ankle, but then at the same time, you don't want it too far apart. So about 3 inches in between your feet, perhaps. Go bend down. You can touch your knees together, just not your feet. Put your hands on your feet and do 10 times each direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, the next stretch will be gliding back and forth. So this is incorporating one of your stances actually, but we'll get into that later. So you're going to glide back and forth. You want your head to be as if on a rail, so you're not going to bob like this, like some other styles will make you do. You'll glide fluidly from side to side with your hands on your knees. Your back is to be straight. Do not go like this, and definitely don't do this. So you'll go and glide. You'll go 10 times each side for a total of 20. So you'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. On your last one, go right down. Your toes pointed up. This opposite foot flat on the ground. You can use your hands for support. If you don't, all the better, because then your body weight will help push the hamstrings right down flat. Hold that for about 10 seconds. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch sides. Again, toes up, foot flat. 3, 7, 8, 9, 10. The next stretch will be, this one is similar to a yoga stretch actually. We're gonna sit, I'll show it from two different angles. Sit like this, cross your foot across your knee. Whichever foot you have across, you're gonna push in the opposite direction with your arm or your elbow, and then you're gonna look behind you in the opposite way, like this. So from here, you'll see I have my left foot crossed at the knee joint. I'm gonna push my left leg to the right. While I'm pushing the left leg to the right, I'm going to stretch my neck to the left. So it's going to look like this for 10 seconds. 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. Don't be afraid to push. These aren't lazy man stretches. They're meant to be very strenuous, very pushing. It helps pull all the ligaments out straight in your muscles. So now it's going to be right leg over left knee. With the right leg, left arm, push to the left. Look to the right. Hold for 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the next one after that will be one-legged push-up. While you're not really doing a push-up, what you are doing is you're going to stretch out all the ligaments in the back of your thigh here. In this area, and it will look something like this. You're going to put your hand on the outside of your ankle. You will not touch this leg on the ground, and you'll go down as far as you can and hold for 10 seconds, trying to keep your body straight. Some people will tend to curve, especially with the lower half, in order to compensate for the stretch. Try to keep your body straight. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then the opposite side. This one I will do this way for the sake of the angle. As you can see, the strictness in line with the mat, some people will start and they'll tend to go like this to relieve the stretch. Make sure that you're not doing that. And you stay in line and straight. And you can bounce. Some people will say that bouncing can be bad, but I disagree with that. I've been taught to bounce. It forces the fascia of your muscles out, like this. So do so. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You'll notice later on, and we'll discuss it, that that actually will improve a kick called the stomp kick we have later. It helps to bring the knees up and all that, but we'll discuss that at a later time. The next one is the cat stretch. What you're going to do is you're going to go forward and backwards 3 times, holding it for 10 seconds at each point. The first one, you're going to go back, stretch out. Actually, you're stretching the front and your abs. Most people actually think you're stretching your back on this one. You're going to look up hard, let your weight sink down on your arms so your shoulders go back and everything. Pull really hard for 10 seconds, then go back the opposite direction. And this one, you're stretching of your back for 10 seconds. Let your arm joints pull out nice and hard. 6, 8, 9, 10. Forward. 8, 9, 10. There you go. 7, 8, 10. For the sake of the ankle, on the last one, I'll turn this way. Third one, you're going to go all the way back With this one, if you need assistance, you may want someone to hold onto your arms or at least pull you back up. What you're gonna do is, if you can, keep your knees together. The closer they are, the harder it's gonna be, so use that at your own discretion, but you're gonna go back like this. Try to relax, lean all the way, and lay on the floor, touch your head, or we'll just go back as far as you can. You can either hold on to your ankles for a little bit of support, depending on how you wanna do it, and just go back. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And the next one is a firefly stretch, where you're gonna go like this. You're gonna put the soles of your feet together. You wanna pull your heels in to your groin as far as possible. Clasp your hands over your toes to pull them in, and you're gonna bounce them like this for about 20 times, keeping nice and tight. That's gonna pull your adductors and your abductors in here and stretch them out. So you go. After that, you're gonna push even more for 10 more times with your elbows on the insides of your legs. So you go like this, pull them in nice and tight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This way you can pull up on your toes, push down with your elbows, and help further get that stretch in. The next one, using the same setup, is you're gonna get a partner to stand on their knees from behind while they brace themselves against your back. We'll show you that one next with a partner. Okay, as with the last stretch, you can also use a partner. They're gonna get on your knees from behind your back. They'll use your back itself as a handle to support themselves. They'll get up and press your knees to the ground. It's essentially the same thing as what you did already. Just be sure that you have this nice and tight. Secure your hands over your hands, and you're gonna step right up onto your knees. And you're gonna hold that for a 10-second count. 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, for someone who doesn't have great flexibility, of course, if your knees are like propped up like this while you're doing it, you can have them bounce on your knees and push the knees down. Like I mentioned before, bouncing is not a bad thing. It will help stretch the fascia and get your knees down to where they need to be. But otherwise, if your knees are touching the floor, then it's okay. You might as well just stand there. There's no need to bounce at that point. Additionally, there's also another method, which I would strongly suggest that you use if you're able to. It's like this with your hands here the same way. You're gonna have two partners, one on either side. Run a bow staff across your knees, right over the knee part, and they're gonna bounce it, push it down. So they use it as a lever, and they're gonna push it all the way down. And then you can even go down and touch the floor the same way. But for this, I will show a clip of Hatsumi Sensei and his senior students doing that.
With every martial art, the most important limbs are the legs. Every ninja must perform daily exercises to keep the legs flexible and nimble. In this particular exercise, remember to keep the legs and the entire body flexible. Try to relax and spread the legs apart as much as possible. Remember to keep the upper torso straight so that the head does not touch the ground first. Mm-hmm. purpose of this exercise is to loosen the muscles and joints around the hips and thighs. In this exercise, slowly tilt the upper torso backwards. Try to keep the back as straight as possible and stretch the stomach muscles. This particular exercise loosens the muscles around the thighs, as well as the stomach and back muscles.
The next stretch is the splits. Now, ideally, you'll want to do them on the ground with your toes pointed up and your back straight. If you have difficulty with that, you may want to buy a stretch machine such as this. So, well, basically, if you have to use one of these, you're going to sit in it like this. I've also bought some straps that I will sometimes put around my knees because I hold my knees down flat. Because I'm tall, they stick off the ends. It has a degree meter here, so it shows the degrees that you're going, and you can track your progress that way. I won't show a full demonstration of this. This is just a very quick run through so that you'll have a basic idea of what it looks like and how it works. Now, this also has three handles. You can pull forward, one to the side, and the other side. It has a notch, a release handle. The opposite direction will release it one notch at a time, so you can reduce it by 1 degree at a time. So essentially, if you have difficulty doing the splits, you'll get one of these. Do this about 10 minutes per day, and then you'll be able to work up to just sitting on the ground and doing it that way. Toes up, never in. It's bad for your knee joints when you do it that way. Try and keep your knees down. If they pop up, use ingenuity, as we sometimes say, to find ways to make it work. There's also another method you may want to use. If it's in class, you don't have 10 minutes, of course, to do this or something similar. You use a partner, and they will assist you in helping get the splits, and we will show you that split, that stretch next. Stretch is still the splits, but this time it's a partner split. So what we're going to do is first rope it with me. You're going to grab your belt. You're going to gently push out on the inside of the thighs with their feet. Okay. You're going to make sure that they don't fall backwards. Now you can use hammer fist, and you're going to just tenderize inside of your thighs a bit. That's where all your tendons are running, right in through here. It helps to relieve the pain and the discomfort and helps to number yourself up a bit. Yeah, a little bit more. Okay. Now, what you're going to hold this for about a minute. When you're the partner, don't push them beyond what they're willing to take, or they'll never want to train with you again. Make sure that there's a comfort zone. Take your cues off of your partner. To know how far to go, when to stop, they'll tell you when to stop. After you hold it about a minute, then you can release. If you don't have a belt, if it's like newer students and they don't have belts, you can always grab the wrists. Something like this, grab each other's wrists. Each other's wrists. Push out on the calf like that. This is only if you have no belt up, so it's demonstrate both ways. Now if you want to get on the inside, you have to pull this in these. If you don't have the belt, obviously this is a little bit harder to do that part, because you need the hands. Now, another benefit too of holding on to each other's wrists they're bright enough, the other person can lean back, even right on their back on the floor, and pull them right forward so that they're like, touching their nose to the ground. Hold that again, like I said, for about a minute, and then release. Always take your cue from your opponent. Always bring your feet back in slowly, otherwise the inside of your thighs will seize up. If you bring them in too quick, then you could hurt yourself. Not permanently, but better to do it properly. Now the next stretch after this is ankle rotations. Basically what you're going to do for this is you're going to lay your ankles across your knees. Put the grip over the ball of your foot and your toes, right in that area. You're going to do full, big rotations, 10 times each direction. 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. Make sure you do nice big circles. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. There is a standing version where you can just rotate your ankle around on the ground, but I prefer this one to get a better stretch, a full range of motion. The standing one, you get a little less of that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, because your feet are at the bottom of your body when you're standing up, blood runs down into your feet through your ankles and back up again. Going down is easy, coming back up is hard. It has to fight gravity, and it's a small space there too compared to the rest of your legs. The Japanese actually believe that rotating your ankles like that will help improve circulation, especially in your feet. And they also believe that a lot of your organs are connected through your feet to nerves and through your arteries and stuff like that. So that actually also partly explains the split of the toe. The Japanese believe that separating your toe helps with good health and long life. We also, as ninja, use it as tools, of course, which we'll get into later. Now, the leggings, too, help with circulation. We wear pant, the tabi, indoor tabi in this case. And in days of old, the ninja would wear leggings, not with velcro, of course, usually tied or perhaps metal clips. The squeezing would control the blood flow, and they could, if they were too hot, they would make it tighter, and it would decrease their blood pressure, decrease their temperature. If they were too cold, they would let it go, and they would become hotter, as well as the wrist gauntlets, or the forearm gauntlets, do the same thing. The tighter you tie them with these, in conjunction with these, when you're traveling or whatever outside, it does the same thing. It's all about body temperature control and all that. So that's our ankle rotation.